Deadlift 225. Wait, 255. Standing press 55, 65, 75, 85, 95. Bent over row. Why can't I remember? Okay, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70. Close grip bench, just knuckle push-ups. 35, 45, 25, 35, 45 per side for curls. Crunch, I do weighted. Crunch, then roller for the ab roller, and then leg. Wait, no, not. Well, I could do leg lifts or the V-ups. What do I got? 30 seconds? I got it.
I spilled my coffee. No.
All right. Get some water, then I'll be ready. Make sure I have some settings. Turn off Bluetooth. Turn on Bluetooth. I just don't want the music from here to hit the microphone. Great, great. Woo! Water, coffee. I'll grab you guys in a second.
I need to grab something to put this computer on. This gets really hot. Sweet. What else? Let's not forget to plug my computer in and have it die like last time. Mess up the screen. What up, dude? I wonder... I have another thing. I use this for the... I have two cameras. I guess I'll just use this one because yesterday it looked really dark in here. All right, I'm about to do the warm up. Hold on. Oh my gosh, no. I'm gonna turn this music. Oh, I guess I could keep the music as like as low as possible. How are you, Banda? What the fudge? What the fuck? Hold on. Why is there a black box? What the fuck is that? Screen share. How do I get rid? I'm gonna delete. I think it's the screen share that's doing it. Yes, delete. There it is. Okay. Problem solved. Almost. I'm just switching something over here real quick. Oh my god. One second. It's finally nice in this workout room. What the fuck? Oh. I messed up. Dude, I was getting destroyed in melee earlier. Who am I watching it with? Alright, sorry. Alright, this should be better. This is going to prepare your joints and your muscles before any physical activity. So if you're ready to get started, we're going to start our dynamic stretch from our head to our feet. Let's start with our neck by looking right and left. You don't want to force it. You want to gently turn your head. Let's go side to side. I can feel my neck going. Semi-circle. Full rotation. If you just look up warm up on YouTube, the Chris Haria video will pop up that I'm doing right now. I have an interview tomorrow.
Have a nice match.
I'm excited. That just means I'll be doing these workouts a lot later in the day. I dream about the day I can do any of these warm-up exercises and not crack every single time.
All right, now we're gonna open up the hip flexors, bring your knees up.
I mean, these don't crack anymore. Out to the side.
Knees up.
Yeah.
Give our ankles a little twist. We're ready to get this warm-up started. And after this, we're ready for any workout routine. And I'll show you guys what I've been working on after our warm-up. So we have five exercises for 45 seconds and 15 seconds rest in between. The first exercise is gonna be jumping jacks. This is gonna warm up our entire body, but really emphasize on our back, our shoulders, our core, and our legs. Let's go for 45 seconds. This is a great moment to really focus on your breathing. Breathe in through your nose, out through your mouth. It's going to be a lot harder when you're doing it with more demanding exercises and when you're more fatigued in the middle of your workout routine. So really focus on your breathing during warm-up and stretches.
That will roll over
to the rest of your workout. Now this next exercise is going to be mountain climbers. This is really going to focus on our shoulders and our core. Now you're going to see that your heart rate is starting to get a bit higher, but just remember, go at your own pace. But if you feel like you're getting a bit fatigued, you can always slow down. Just try not to stop no matter what. Let's go for it. Remember to squeeze everything. You want to squeeze your core. You want to bring your knees as high as you can. Give it a full range of motion. You're giving quality in your warm-up, you're going to give quality in your whole entire workout. Make sure you're gripping the ground solid, and you're pushing your arms down as hard as you can. Make sure you're breathing, we're going to give it our last ones. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Excellent. Just remember, you should be going at your own pace, and if you need to, complete the rest of the repetitions with the progression, like knee push-ups. But regardless, you're either doing push-ups or knee push-ups, both targeting the same muscle groups. Let's go for it. 45 seconds, we don't want to stop. Thank you. muscle that much.
One, two, three. If you're able to follow along with me, you are a beast. Okay. Is the music good? Do the warm-up squats. Bar first. Usually, sometimes this feels like the hardest. I have injuries and stuff. So. Knuckles feeling a little tight, actually.
How's your guys' day? Good? It's finally getting a little bit colder in here.
Ooh, there's something moved on the bar. A little scary. Third set of spots right here, out of five. But after this, I always hang upside down, stretch out my back. Try to anyway. I'm gonna stand under. There's some wind right here, I can feel. Whenever my hair grows out just a little bit, I always feel like shaving it. I'll let it grow out this time. Alright, third set. Anyone's new here, I'm not trying to like power lift crazy heavy weights. I'm just trying to stay consistent. Not injure myself. What up? The day I start waking up at 4:30 in the morning, now that's gonna be the day I decided to be a responsible adult. Who knows, maybe it could happen soon. I mean, this job interview core, I used to wake up at 5 a.m. because the job starts at 6:30, so that's 30 minutes. Feel that.
This used to hurt my legs, but I'm used to it now.
I know, it's what? Waking up that early in the morning, it's like...
Start going to bed at 5 p.m. The one thing I like about starting work earlier is that you get off earlier, but then, you know... I'm always careful. At least I try to be. I can't be injuring myself without health insurance. It feels good on my back. Stretches everything out. I used to have really bad hip pain, and my chiropractor told me that I should hang upside down to pull out my hips. He's saying something about me running all the time was like shoving my hip bone into my leg bone. I don't know, whatever. Long story short, pulling the pressure off my back and my hips. The whole point of hanging upside down. After this, I'm going to put the belt on for the final set. Hold on.
You get used to the pain. Hold on, I'm going to turn this down. I think there might be some overlap for the audio. What the fuck did I put my... Oh, there it is. Okay. I know that the back of my legs used to hurt, like behind my knee. Let's see. All right, sweet. We're in business. You guys ever get spam calls? Whenever I get a spam call, I always look up the phone number, and it's usually some... I know, right? I haven't had a massage in forever. Who was it that said they don't like massages? I think it was like Chris D'Elia or some shit. He's like, no, I don't like getting massages. I was like, that's weird. Who doesn't like fixing their back problems and stuff?
I bet the massage you got today was amazing. I always get the typical, oh, wow, you've been keeping a lot of tension in your back. I can tell you. I don't know if they actually can tell or they're just saying that to try to keep you coming back. Part of their spiel. Wow, you're super tense. And at the end, yeah, you're much more relaxed now. bar just moved again. Yeah, I Google the number. I go to images and videos. 100% of the time, something X-rated pops up, and that's when I know for a fact it's not a business calling me. Because you know they're probably using the same numbers for a bunch of other scams, too. I interviewed at a competitor for Google Voice. Sorry, I can't talk right now. I interviewed for a Google Voice competitor, and here's like tinfoil hat theory comes in, but the number for the recruiter at the Google Voice competitor came up as potential spam. And I think Google, a lot of the executives at this company were previous Google Voice employees. I'm over here thinking Google's over here trying to kill the competition, putting spam likely on their competitors. Because you know Google and Android, all that bullshit. Probably the fastest way to kill your competition is put spam likely on your competitors' numbers. It's smart. I mean, how would you not take the advantage if you had it in business anyway? It's like, whatever. Yeah, I told the recruiter, I'm like, oh, sorry I didn't answer the first time. I saw spam likely and I just ignored it. I just found a no copyright hard style list. Just because I've been listening to Tevez, whatever, the same list for like the past three workouts. So I just figured I'd change it up for the sake of the video. What's up? What's up, bro? Dude, I posted the video to YouTube and then I took it down. I was like, nah, Yeah, they don't leave a voice message. Dude, did you see the video I posted on YouTube? Is this a silly... This dude was putting Snickers inside of a pickle. And then he's calling it a snickle. And he's like, yeah, I take 2 to 3 of these to work every day. I'm like, bro, you're telling me you eat 3 fucking Snickers a day. That you wrap up in rubber bands to make it travel size. And then it has a price tag on the fucking Snickers too. $2. $1.79, excuse me, but I round up at that point. You're spending $1.79 per Snickers that goes inside the pickle. Like, what in the pregnancy cravings is going on here? So I should have put like a beat behind it, but I was like, $2 sticker on a Snickers. Snickers, pickle. Snickers inside I don't know, it's whatever. I thought it was fucking hilarious, though. I was laughing like a maniac on the YouTube video.
A pickle Rick!
Yeah, I was just fucking around. I wonder what the views are at. I haven't posted a YouTube short in a while. I'm going to check it real quick. I'm just stalling for time to rest. For some reason, I've been... Oh, yeah, it's at the same. Oh, well, who cares? Dude, YouTube shorts are so weird. Maybe I'll delete it and then put an actual beat behind it so it sounds better. Yeah, I'll just delete it and then make it better. $2 sticker for a Snickers, then he's have a little bit more of like a rap vibe to it. It's more of like a $2 sticker for
like monotone. Okay.
Woo! Okay, no more stalling. Okay, one more stalling. Drinking some coffee. Okay. I thought this fell off. I was one notch looser than normal. Oh, I can't turn the music on because I watched that YouTube video. Oops. Okay, now I'm going for real. I felt good today. Oh, you can't hear it? There's music playing, but the music's so low, it must not be registering. Is that better? Oh, I can turn it up a little bit. Okay, I need to turn it down just a tad. So I don't want it to overlap with a microphone. I could move the microphone though, that might help. Is that better? No, you're great. Yeah, thanks for the heads up. I had it when I started the video. There was a big black box over here by the chat. All right, let me take care of this. I got deadlift. I saw a video recently that the wrist.
the risk of reward isn't that good for deadlift.
No, professional football players and stuff don't. You don't see them doing deadlift. Do they hurt themselves? Have to sit out a game? Well, that's how the $1 million in their contract just fizzles out. So I'm still doing it, but I'm not doing a lot. Just 255. But you see those people doing like 600 pound deadlifts and shit like that. Maybe if I put it to compete or something, take some TRT, some friend. No, I'm just kidding. I'll stick to my creatine, fish oil, and joint health pills. Dude, I was getting destroyed on melee earlier today. So frustrating. This fucking Mario bro is so good. I looked him up on YouTube. He has a YouTube? But he must have just started his YouTube stuff because he only had 2 subscribers. But I made sure to subscribe to him. Oh, this has been sketching me out all day today. Oh, you can't see what's going on.
Sorry.
This shit's been moving like... Damn marbles. Yeah, right when I think I get it on, it's not on. It's like fucking broken or some shit. I just want it to stay. Me personally, I like to try to check my gear.
Bro, I feel that in my soul.
Just dreams like... I swear I had a dream like that. I can't remember it, but... I spent all my money and I'm like, no! I'm a brokey. Wait.
This angle's fucking... weird. It's not.
Is that good? Dude, my right or my left knee pop like crazy on that. I mean, I don't have my leg pop I'd rather have my leg pop on lightweight instead of big weight having fucking.
Ice cream fitness program only calls for one set, but for squats and deadlifts, I like to do an extra warm-up set.
So I stopped using the wrist straps and stuff for these.
I feel like it's been helping. Because here's my theory anyway.
Yeah.
Come on, Vinny.
So I have like carpal tunnel in my right wrist. I've been using these. But I feel like having this pull my wrist trying to lift heavy weight isn't doing me any favors. Even if I have this wrist brace on. So I've just been straight grabbing the bar. I feel like it's helping my hand. Having like the use my fingers, you know, just pull the bar up.
Let's get this out of the way.
Chug, 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 chug.
Woo!
Okay, speaking of chugging, I'm gonna drink some water too.
There's part of me that wants to just put it on the ground and do it, but I'm not sure if I want to do that quite yet.
That's all good.
I'll put the camera on me taking the weights off over here.
Snickers in a pickle. Snickers getting pickle getting thicker with the Snickers in the middle. It's not like you have to chug water, but it's probably good to be on the safe side. Protect yourself. If you don't protect yourself, who is? Wait, I think I'm doing the wrong thing here. Oh, yeah, I am. I guess I didn't do anything wrong. I just preemptively set up. Different exercise.
I don't really like how that looks. Oh, I'm a genius.
I wasn't sure it would be the best category for this video between sports, health, and fitness. I feel like health and fitness might be better because just me doing fitness stuff for health. But weightlifting is a sport? No, not really. I mean, there's competitions, but not like how much you, I don't know.
Yeah, I think health and fitness is a better tag.
This is not just chatting. I'd say fitness and health. Fitness and health over just chatting, I'd say. So my attention's usually like divided between. We're still talking though, so I don't know. I'd say fitness and health, probably better than sports. I'm working on my health the whole time. Now, when I'm done working out and stuff, maybe I could change it to just chatting, because then I'm just making my food and stuff properly. Unless I'm showing you guys how to make healthy food, but I don't think anyone wants to learn how I eat. It's nothing. The way I eat, just microwave. Well, for lunch I'll microwave potatoes and eat tuna, but for dinner I'll cook rice. Cook rice or noodles, eat some. I need to buy some more rotisserie chickens and make like chicken wraps. Tuna water, yeah, just straight tuna water, not even the meat, just drinking tuna water. Oh yeah, I didn't understand what Catherine meant when she's like, "Oh, I'm glad I didn't get to see that." I was like, "What? What did I do?"
And then I rewatched the video and I saw the chat. Where's the chat? I saw the chat was blocking. What's in your water bottle? Like Bert Kreischer? Oh, I'm gonna change the music to Tevez. What's in your water bottle? Gatorade. What color is it? Red. Dude, Bert drinking a big ass bottle of Gatorade every day is the funniest thing. Alright, it sounds better. Tom Segura's like, wait, what the fuck's in your big ass water bottle? That's all Gatorade?
I don't know if I did this, I'm just gonna do it again if I did. Everyone, I don't even know what I'm gonna say. I'm just really surprised that they still talk to Ari Shaffir after that guy drugged Bert the day before he was leaving to go on tour for months and ruined his next month after. I guess maybe they're more work friends, but even if they are work friends, I don't see how you just let that slide. Apparently, according to the internet, he had mean stuff to say about one of Bert's children, too. At some point, I just started giving up on watching anything with Bert Kreischer or Tom Segura after that. I mean, they're disappointed at first, but I mean, they're still hanging out with them, so I mean, they're sort of giving a pass in some degree, I feel like. Stay with me. Hey, it's not my friendship. I just can't stand seeing anything with Ari Shaffir in it now. What's up, people? Stay with me. Excited. I have 2 interviews tomorrow at a place I've worked previously. I'm very familiar with the company and stuff. I just gotta study the prompt they gave me. So
so I nail it. I had both the hiring managers check out my LinkedIn profile. I'm like, what's up? Talk to you tomorrow. Dude, it's actually really scary seeing all the layoffs on LinkedIn. I've been in recruiting and stuff for the past like 2 years. There's layoffs. Everyone's laying off their recruiters. Not a good time to be in recruiting, so now I'm switching back to sales. I've been exclusively looking for remote jobs. I know at some point I might not have the luxury to only try to look for remote jobs, but who wants to drive for X amount of time a day with gas prices the way they are? Or just stay at home? Well, I do see the benefit of going in the office in some capacity, but I'd rather not. Then you see all these like LinkedIn posts telling like everyone's so excited to go back to the office. I'm like, no. It's like written by companies that want you back to the office so they can micromanage you to the bone. Everyone's so excited to come back into the office. Mike, where are you getting these people? I mean, some jobs you can't do it. You have to go to the office and stuff. I just get that. Okay, let's switch over to bent over a row. Bench up a little bit, and then I can do bent over row relatively easy. I feel like it's increased my back a little bit too, just having to, instead of doing bent over row, where I instead of doing bent over row where I pick it up like this and then set it down, whatever, I'll lay this way and then do bent over row laying down. Yeah, right?
at a previous job of mine, we'd have three meetings a day. Three.
A day.
Then I'd have like multiple managers, all of them telling me to do something a little bit different, and then they'd be like, how can you not do this? Like I told you, I'm like, well, this person told me to.
Messy.
I bet you they have questions like, so how do you like the job? How are you doing?
It's trash. We really don't need two, I know.
I remember, okay, so here's the thing about sales. Every sales job I've ever had, they teach you how to sell. No. They teach you how to sell their way. And then they use the same selling techniques to manipulate you to be a better employee. So here's an example. I was selling cars, my first sales job. And they taught you, you know, bring the customers in, have them sit down at the table, because if they sit down because you told them to, now you're in control. It was a really shitty car dealership, by the way. It's not in business anymore. But then they're like doing a one-on-one with me. And the manager, straight from the fucking playbook, Defno, have a seat. And I'm like, no, I'll stand. You tell me what you need to tell me, but I'm standing this whole one-on-one. Because I know to them what that symbolizes is that I'm taking, that they have power over me, right? And I was a lot more confrontational. Like now I can fight my battles, but at the time I was like, no, I'm not sitting down. I'm gonna stand during this whole meeting. Like, you can't tell me that's how you manipulate the customers and then expect me to just, oh yeah, I'll take a seat. I remember one time I had a customer. Scammed like low wage, or what do you mean? Are they making you work hours and not paying you for it? You gotta look out for yourself, because these companies, you can't expect them to uphold their word. Companies will make promises. Oh, push back. Oh, we'll give you that raise when you do this. We'll give you that. And then you do it, and they're like, oh, well, you haven't actually made enough money.
Like, I remember I got fucking rookie of the year at the staffing company, highest performing newcomer, and they still had the audacity to tell me I'm not going to get a raise because I didn't hit the numbers. I'm like, bitch, if I'm the best performing person in the whole GD company, you're still going to straight face tell me I'm not going to get a promotion because I didn't hit the numbers? Like, you fucking gave me a $1,500 bonus check. Fuck off.
The thing is, that manager that said that to me, he was so manipulative and good at sales. It's like, you would think it's a good deal, and then you walk out of the meeting and you're like, wait, I just got scammed. What the fuck? How do you do that? Some people are just... have that big brain. You know, it's like, can't get scammed if I don't let you talk to me in the first place. I mean, you can't do that at work, but... yeah, dude. Oh, you're not getting a raise because you didn't hit them. You're not making us enough money. Bitch, I made you fucking $400,000 that year. And gross profit, not just sales.
What? They don't have like an actual job for you yet?
Are you doing other people's jobs that would require more pay? Because then you definitely got scammed. But you're doing other people's jobs that are lesser?
Maybe they don't have, yeah, maybe they just don't have, they want to keep you on, but they don't have the workload yet. That's weird.
Now, if they're having you do, like, pay that would require a higher pay scale, like, you can look at the contract that they gave you in the first place. You can look at the contract they gave you in the first place, and if they give you stuff outside your job duties, like, hey, that's, like, something, you know, pick your battles, but you could say, hey, this isn't my scope of work. I was hired on to do this, so I don't want to, I don't know, don't take me, this is not career advice. My brother is like a sales manager at some farm, like, chemical company. He's super smart, my oldest brother. He says stuff like that all the time, like people don't communicate or they're happy with them bleeding money out because they're still making a profit technically. Or the lack of training for their salespeople. Oh, my headphone. What? The program I'm doing, KKDSD, is a free program. If you look up Ice Cream Fitness for muscle and strength.
I should. They never said anything about product development and marketing. What the fuck? Like, hey, look at this contract I signed. Well, if you do, I'd have... you're looking... just keep on looking if you have something.
Try to get Here's a pro strat to get more money. Pro strat right here. Have another job that's gonna pay you more. And then tell them, like, hey, I'm not doing my assigned duties that you originally hired me on for. I'm trying to grow my career. And this company isn't doing what you promised. So I have another job with more pay, so I'm putting my 2 weeks notice in. And then they'll try to give you a counteroffer. If they give you a counteroffer, that means that they could have paid you at the higher wage from the start. So then it's like, oh, okay, so you're giving me a counteroffer for better pay, which you could have been giving me in the first place, meaning that you can screw me over from the very beginning. No, I'm going to take this other offer. Boom! That's usually what people do in software development fields. Have a job, passively look, find a better paying job, put in the notice. Sometimes they'll get a counter offer and take it, but you, as a recruiter, that's when you just have to make sure, like, as a recruiter, you're trying to get placements. So if you know that a person's going to get a counter offer, and you have to try to coach them, like, hey, what would you do if you get a counter offer? Are you going to take it? Oh, yeah, I'd probably take it. Like, you know they could have paid you that from the start, right? They're screwing you over from the beginning. Because, of course, I'm trying to get them... Shit. I'm trying to get them hired for whatever company I'm recruiting for. This is why I set a bet over row. And my close grip breath. Close grip retention increase. Dude, my wrist feeling funky. I don't know what I did. One more for good luck. Woo!
What's up, people? Yeah, I had family at my house, so I couldn't. I wasn't going to work out with I'm going to pause this other let's go get away. They say what they gonna say. Have a drink, click, found a Bud Light. Bad bitches like me, it's hard to come by. The Patron, let's go get it down. The sound, yes, I'm in the sound. Is it 2, 3, leave a good tip. I'm gonna blow all of my money and don't get I should learn how to hard style. I'm going to switch it back. I know, I just didn't want to try to stream my workouts with other people walking in on the thing. What's my next workout, actually? Yeah, it is close grip bench. I got really lazy. Look how sloppy my chart is. Let's look at last week's. Here's last week's chart. It's all colorful and stuff. Straight lines. I was just like, fuck it. Black. See, when I used to study in college, I like to, the more colorful it is, the more I'm trying to keep myself entertained and in with it, but I don't really need the colors this week. Just pure black. But yeah, see, I was thinking of streaming something else. I need to get a better phone plan so I could just go on walks and just stream, like, what up? I have a 360 camera. I need to figure out how to get that connected to my computer. And then I can stream with the 360 camera. It'd be cool if it could, like, if I had my 360 camera and you could choose what to look at from the stream, but I don't know if that's possible. I could probably, see, I learned how to put Snap Camera as one of the cameras, and now I could put, like, filters on my face. I mean, why would I put a filter on my face while I'm, like, looking out? But I've been making, I only made, like, two Omegle trolling videos. But this computer I'm using is a little slow, so it's not really. I need to get it better. I need to fix my gaming PC that's sitting over there. Okay, close grip bench. Easy. I like the 360 camera because you can just film, right? It's filming everything. And then in post, you can choose what to look at, what to track. Insta360X or Insta361X, I forgot what it's called. Okay, so this is. We're at this. Alright, I'm just gonna angle it down a little bit. That's better. Okay, so instead of doing close grip bench, anyone's new here, I just do knuckle push ups. So, close grip bench, I just put my knuckles together inward, and then do that. My shoulder has been healed for a while, but I don't know. Maybe I'll actually switch the bench eventually. This is my 11th week on the program, so then after this 11th week, I'm gonna have a 12th week, then a week rest. Tap my head on that weight and scare myself. Woo! I don't know. I have like carpal tunnel in my right wrist and surgery in my left. I broke my wrist longboarding. I was going like 35 miles an hour. In California, I was going down. I was in Palm Springs longboarding, just bombing this hill, and I had someone following me in the car, and I was going so fast. I was going faster than they could keep up in the vehicle, and then I had this really fast turn come up, and I tried to turn, but I had zero experience going that fast. When I tried to turn, instead of like, you know, speed wobbles, you like go a little crazy. I had my board like doing like vicious speed S's and I got ejected. I have like, you probably can't see, but I have scars all down my body from it. Me and Road Rash are pretty good friends. I know Road Rash on a personal level. See, the person who tried to help me said that they were a nurse and they put hydrogen peroxide on my injury. That shit hurt! I guess hydrogen peroxide might be good for the first decontamination, but what it does, if you keep on using hydrogen peroxide on a wound, No, that was wrong. If you keep on using hydrogen peroxide, your wound will never heal. It keeps on burning the outer layer. It, like, destroys the cells.
H2O2 and it oxidizes organic material. And I saw a video under a microscope what happens with hydrogen peroxide. The cell has like little air bubbles come inside of it and it just explodes.
I know, I guess people are using TikTok instead of Google now.
I can't imagine that. I'm gonna grab my coffee real quick. Oh man, I see some crazy stuff on TikTok.
Why not after?
I'm just changing my music over here. That's a good song. I learned how to Mongolian throat sing off of YouTube. See if I can do it. No, I'm not gonna do it. I posted on YouTube though a video of me doing it. Well, no, I'm not. Maybe I'll do that. Let me see. I'm not gonna do it. I don't want to embarrass myself, and because I can't do it all the time. But if you look on my YouTube channel, Death Note, I do a video of me. There's a video of me doing it. It has like a couple, like 1,000 views. I was trying to do it earlier before I started working out. It was... the British accent. Hello, mate. I just watched Shanghai Nights, Jackie Chan and Owen Wilson. That's a good movie. Okay, last set of post-grip bench. Knuckle, post-grip, knuckle push-ups. What I wanted to start doing is I've heard of Shanghai Nights. I love that movie. What? I need to start doing these. I work out my shoulders, play some light weights. My shoulders are popping all crazy when I do these. I don't know if it's because I just need to learn how to use my shoulders better, or if they're just fucked up. I want to get those Death Star shoulders.
If anyone watches More Plates, More Dates, he does fitness videos. You can call him. What was another one? He was like, hold on, I'm just doing a light one today. Woo! That did not feel good at all. The fact that it doesn't feel good makes me want to do more. Woo! That did not feel good either. Dude, my left shoulder keeps on popping. Dude, yeah, that feels better. I was going straight out, but I need to do it like a little bit different. Whatever. And then here's the last thing I saw him do. Kind of work out your backside. It's like, the fact that I'm only using 5 pounds, my shoulders feel this sore. I think that's a good sign. I just gotta keep it up. All right, I think I'm going to start. I'm not going to eat potatoes today. I think I'm going to make some rice for lunch. I'm just going to make some rice. Oh, shit. Okay, I'll just put my laptop on top of my bowl. Dude, this is my most popular YouTube video as of late. How to make rice. Look it up. Def No on YouTube. 32,000 views of me just doing what I'm doing right now. Except it's edited to shit. I just put my rice in. Just a little extra. Then I'll put it on for like 12 minutes or so. That's all. 14 to 17 minutes, I mean. I'm trying to find the middle ground between. Someone said jasmine rice is already seasoned on the YouTube video. I'm like, bro, I'm washing my rice off regardless. I don't care. Someone else said that's extra nutrients in the rice that I shouldn't be washing off. I don't care. I'm rinsing off my rice. at least a couple times. And then I don't put a lid on it, but I just put a little bit extra water. Yeah, I know, I don't have... Get a rice cooker, bro, it's so much easier. Like, how much easier does cooking rice have to be? It's already super easy. I just prepared the rice. I'll probably smell the rice being done.
Before. Hold on, you know what? I'll put it down just a little bit. That should be good. Okay, let's go back to the curls. I just have curls and abs. I'm thinking by the time I'm done with the workout, then I'll be
ready to eat rice. I don't think you need to see my feet, do you? Another comment I got on that how to make rice video. If anyone's new here, I have a YouTube channel, just Death Note on YouTube. Someone said you should put the salt in the rice so it's seasoned into the rice. Someone said I put too much salt. I had every kind of comment on. I personally just like to put some salt after the fact because when it's cooked into it, it just tastes different versus just plain rice with some salt on top of it versus salty rice. I'm right-handed, so I need to focus on my left arm a little bit. I'm trying to get my left arm to look like my right. I mean, they look the same for the most part. Oh, I forgot what rep I'm on. Alright, well that should be good. What's up, people? Woo! So instead of taking pre-workout, I've just been coffee, salt. That's my pre-workout. I used to buy pre-workout stuff, but I'm just trying to save money right now, and the pre-workout I was getting was like $55. So expensive. Yeah, I saw some fitness dude was saying that if you take salt before a workout, it'll help put water in your muscles. I like that. More Plates, More Dates was saying that the C4 workout, or the C4 pre-workout, the C4 pre-workout is basically just flavored caffeine, so if it's just flavored caffeine, I might as well just buy coffee and drink that. But I'm sure if I start buying some good pre-workout, I'd probably see some pain. But I never really know if I can trust any like of those fitness influencers that have their own private label substances, because then they're
they're going to be motivated to tell you to buy their stuff over other people just because they have monetary, like, they have money to gain from it. But, I mean, not always, but it's always good to think about, think critically about it. Like what Coach Greg sells terkestrone, and I've never even heard what the fuck that was until he was saying, "Oh, I take that now." And I've seen other people say it doesn't work, but I guess the only way to know is if you do it yourself, right? I'm not gonna spend $50 on a fucking bottle of shit like that. No. But I do take creatine though, so you know that works. Fish oil, glucosamine, glucosamine's just those little pills you can take for joint health stuff. I do try to have like fish oil, and that's those joint pills, glucosamine helps. I mean, I think it helps. It just gets. Apparently there's some fish oil that doesn't have the amount of the omega-3 fatty acids that it claims to have, or have like... I'm sure I lost count there too. I don't know. Was that 8? So I was messing around with the nunchucks earlier, and I accidentally, I hit the fan. I was like, oh my god. I knew that was gonna happen. Alright, let's go check on the rice.
It's looking pretty good. Hold on, let me see. Can you see? So I got 9 meds.
Phase 1's a pretty good band. Hanging by a thread.
Does the music sound good? I'm gonna play. This is one of my. I used to love this Bone Thugs and Harmony song. I mean, I still love it. Hey, Jeffy. Dude, Jeffy reminds me of that one song from, not song. Jeffy from Johnny Knoxville's movie. Why can't I think of the Special Olympics movie he was in? That was his name, anyway, Jeffy. Yeah, I've listened to the song so many times. You need your basic information before you can leave Earth with the BIBLD, the source of the true words, faith is dead without work. You need your basic information before you can leave Earth, and the BIBLD is the source of the true words. Woo! Faith is dead without words from the minute you was birthed. Alright, I just have this and abs. Depends what it is. If I can't do it, I'll just tell you I can't do it. What is it? I just did squats, deadlift, bent over row, standing press. What else did I do? I can't. Instead of close grip bench, I just did knuckle push-ups. Put it for the Lord. Okay, let's go back to the playlist before. Woo! Almost tripped. While I wait for you to give me the challenge, I'm gonna start cleaning up my area. What was that movie with Johnny Knoxville and James Jeffy? His fake. God, it's gonna bother me. I can't remember what the name was. Let's see, did you give me a challenge yet? Let's go check the rice while you. I laughed so hard. He's like, hey, can I give you a challenge? And then just dipped. I'm all waiting here all day. Oh, the rice is looking better. I'm just gonna shake it up a little bit, switch it around. Okay, see, it says 3 minutes, but I turned it down a little bit. I usually have it higher, so I might need to increase the time. I will. Just kidding. Dude, Almighty Bandit, when you remind me of me. Because I used to say that to my swim coach. I'd call him old man and stuff. All the time. Now I'm the old man. It's come full circle. Yeah, I'm just gonna start
have abs, so. Oh fuck, that's a fucking list.
Oh fuck. Okay, here's the challenge. Standing up, I'm just gonna step by step try to do this. Wait, are you trying to trick me to do this? Where I'm like, you know what I mean? Or is that, I'm thinking of something else. Oh, no, no. I'm thinking of the one where they tell a guy to put his hands like this and then lift his back leg up and then they make a funny sound. Standing up, put both your hands behind your back, lock the fingers. Lock the fingers. Palms of your hands are close. Okay. So like this, right? And try to move over your leg one by one, slow and steady until your hand, without separate, reaches your front. That should be... I don't know if you know this, but I used to, when I was a kid, before I had more muscle on my back, I used to be able to go like this and then bring my hands over my head. Do you want me to go like this? And go like this? Is that what you want me to do? Or do I have to have my hands together more? Go. Together. This is it, right?
Here, I'll show you something else I can do if that's more challenging. Unless I did it wrong.
Let's see. Let me make some room. Okay. Here's something else I can do. Hold on. Fuck. Let me turn off the stove. Not gonna lie, that was pretty hard still because I couldn't get my arms down because it was like as easy as I thought I'd be able to. Okay, here's the other thing. I'm gonna take this headphone out. Oh crap, it's in my ear still. Alright, this is... I don't care. Yeah, go for it. Hold on, let me show you this one. Oh, let me make some... I need to change the angle. Okay. I can't do it like some of those calisthenic people. Then I used to go. If I had more room, then I'd try to do it like... What's that one thing? Woo! Oh my god, cramp! Hold on, I need to go check on the rice. See, the original goal was stay balanced like this, go over, and then jump back onto my feet. It used to be easier to do that when I weighed less. If you're here on Monday, I showed a video of me 30 pounds lighter when I was unhealthy. But having more upper body, like, you know, more muscle now, it's doing those acrobatic type things are a little harder. Okay, the rice is done. How's that look? Is that... Maybe you can cook a little bit longer. I'm not too worried about it. Let's see. Let's see what I'm going to eat with my rice. I have 4 hard-boiled eggs. I'm going to eat with a can of tuna. I'm just gonna let the rice chill for a bit. Let the moisture settle in a little bit better. I still have abs to do. I spaced it. I'm glad that you liked the trick.
I used to be able to, oh shit. I plugged in my
computer and it got laggy. Okay. Hold on, I'm gonna... I'm gonna move you guys down. Okay. This should be better. If it's a 45-pound plate, I'm just gonna...
All right, I will. I'm gonna do the abs, and then I'll do that once I'm done with. I have 3 sets of 30 different ab exercises. I used to have to take breaks for these, but now I don't really need breaks as much. Halfway there for the set. 16. 18. 19. 20. The front, down on the floor, with hands behind the back, lock the fingers close to the palms too. So like, wait, you want me to get up with just my legs? Like this? Is that what you want? Lie front down on the floor. I think I saw a video on this.
It's not good. I think it's...
I'm pretty sure it was like this, right?
I'm pretty sure... If that's not it, then... I saw a video. Someone getting up that way.
They just push their leg out to the side. Yeah, I've got 30 ab rollers. What's up? Hold on, I can't read your message, but I can see it's there. You have 8, 9, 10, 11. Twelve.
13.
Before I do the last 15, I'll read the messages.
No, I don't. I haven't heard of the Burpee Stick Challenge either. I don't even know where to start. It's all good. 12-12.
I just try to eat 3 big meals a day. So my breakfast, a cup of oats, either a can of tuna or 4 eggs with a couple spoonfuls of non-fat Greek yogurt, a banana and blueberries. That's my breakfast every morning. And then lunch, same thing. I'll have, not same thing, but I'll still eat tuna or eggs, depending if I had eggs or tuna for breakfast. But I'll have either potatoes, like I'll get like a nice handful of potatoes, clean them off, stab them, microwave them 5 minutes per side. Sometimes I'll make mashed potatoes, or I'll just eat them like a psychopath, no flavor, just bite them, water. And I'll have some eggs and stuff, or tuna, depending if I had for breakfast. And then dinner, it'd either be like rice or noodles with eggs and tuna.
Eggs and tuna, eggs and or tuna, or I'll buy steak.
And then I'll make like, if I eat steak for dinner, then I'll, sometimes, lately I've been throwing some eggs on top of the steak. I'll cook the eggs over easy in the steak juices and stuff. And just eat it like that. You don't have to waste any of the fats and stuff. I see a lot of bodybuilders like cut out all the fats and stuff. Bro, I don't need every bit of fat I can get. It's hard for me to keep weight on, but I'm not eating 5 times a day like rich Tina or whatever. I'm only eating 3 times a day, so I'm sure I should eat more. That guy was eating 8 times a day sometimes. Rich Pita, he's like 300 pounds. I mean, he was on a bunch of stuff and professional bodybuilder, but I've been watching Rich Pina's, am I saying his last name right? Rich Pina? I don't know. I've been watching his videos a lot lately. He's talking about how he loves eating. Is he still lucky to eat as much as he wants compared to people that have to starve? That's a good way to look at it. Shit. Need to focus on this. Woo! I lost count, so I'm gonna do 5 more. Okay, I just got some V-ups and then I'll be done with the workout. Anchovies is good. I used to eat those. Or no, sardines. The thing about sardines, I'll get them in like tomatoes. The sardines taste so bad by the time I'm done eating it. I just feel so happy. I think the sardines do increase your mood. But I also think they taste pretty bad. I'll make myself eat them still. By the time I'm done eating them, I'm just like, thank the Lord. Anything's better than having to eat the whole can of 40 plus grams of protein in a sardine can. But yeah, I saw that too. In the tuna and water, I buy like the
I've been noticing these little black specks, but they look like microplastics, and I'm starting to freak out. Like, it could be, like, I don't understand what would be the little black specks, but it's like, it looks like a fiber. I eat them a lot every day. Yeah, Jeffy, I don't know if I can do that one. Laying on the floor, any wooden stick to put below your arm. Oh, like a... I get it now. I don't know if I have a long wooden stick. But yeah, I do eat the... I eat a fuckload of tuna. The reason why I stopped eating chicken, because I... First off, I don't like fucking around with chicken, because I feel like it's... Whatever it touches is like poisoning the area because of salmonella. I don't know. I'm just scared of it. But the main reason why I stopped eating chicken, that's not a problem. I could put soap, clean it off. But the real reason I stopped eating chicken is because I would buy it and then it'd go bad the next day. And then I'm over here. I'm out. However, tens of dollars. I know, tens of dollars. Ugh. I just don't like wasting food. And I buy chicken, I feel like I waste it. So that's why I just eat. Primarily eggs and tuna. I'll buy steak and have that for dinner, you know, because I will go out to Wendy's and stuff to get like a $5 biggie bag. But I try not to do it too much. But I'm pretty cheap, so my food's pretty cheap too. Yeah, you just have to do what you like. Oh, you could buy rotisserie chicken. That's good. You can. Here's something I want to start doing is rotisserie chicken. Maybe like avocado for good fats, whatever. I'm not like nutritionist or anything. I'm just trying to eat what I like. And you could buy some greens, throw it in there. And then like some type of healthy wrap or and I'd probably just choose a tortilla, but I'm sure there's better wraps. Coach Greg always has these videos of him showing like 500 calories, or here's 250 calories of, like, it'll be like a unhealthy tortilla with a little bit of like drizzled sauce on it. Okay, here's 250 calories, just a wrap with some sauce. Boom, just unhealthy. And then you'll have a healthy wrap loaded with vegetables and chicken, and that's the same amount of calories, apparently. I guess popcorn's a good snack as well. I bought some popcorn I eat. What else? Honestly, I eat pretty boring. Like, I'll have, like, vegetables. I try to have fruits and vegetables in every meal. So, like, breakfast, I don't have any vegetables because it's oatmeal and stuff. But I'm going to do my V-ups.
Dude, I'll have to try to find that a stick. A stick to put behind my back and try to get up. That'd be hard as hell. Yeah, for lunch today, I'm gonna eat a cup of rice. No, I put the whole cup of rice. Maybe some carrots and like a cucumber or something, like half a cucumber. Or a can of tuna, or two cans of tuna, or 8 eggs, depends. Whatever can get me to 50 grams of protein. I always shoot for 50 grams of protein, types of carbs like oatmeal for breakfast, potatoes for lunch, rice for dinner. That's like my go-to. With protein and vegetables out there for meals.
Okay, I'm gonna do more because this song's on and it's good.
Well, that's the workout. Yeah, I'm gonna do some pull-ups, some chin-ups.
I have a pull-up bar outside too, but I'm just gonna do them in here. Hey, if you guys could follow, I'd appreciate it. I'm just doing this for fun, though. In my free time, I'm not. Ideally, if I could do this instead of having to work in an office, but. I need to do more pull-ups. The chin-ups, whatever. Well, that's that. I'll see you guys. I'm gonna go eat. Thanks for stopping by. Have a great day. And I'm out.